Good morning, brothers and sisters in Christ, and welcome to this Tuesday morning's morning devotion.
Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us.
And welcome to this morning's service. We thank you for joining us, and we pray that your hearts will be filled with the Holy Spirit as we give God thanks, praise, and share our joy together in today's service. Our service continues on page 33 in our Books of Common Prayer. The glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together. Blessed be the Lord our God, by whose grace we are yet alive. Blessed be his Son, Jesus Christ, by whose rising we are set free. Blessed be the Spirit of God, in whom is our hope and our joy. Together. Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship be a witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. Christ, our Passover. Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed for us. So let us celebrate the feast, not with the old leaven of corruption and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Christ, once raised from the dead, dies no more. Death has no more dominion over him. In dying, he died to sin once for all. In living, he lives to God. See yourselves, therefore, as dead to sin, and alive to God in Jesus Christ, our Lord. Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who sleep. For us, by man came death, by man has come also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ all shall be made alive. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. At this point in time, we take a moment to reflect on what God has told us, the instructions He gave us that we chose not to do, the things He told us not to do, but we still did, and all the things that we either know or we don't even know that we did wrong. So let us reconnect ourselves in God's grace as we ask God to forgive us our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Psalms for today are Psalms 26 and 28. Psalms 26 and 28.
Psalm 26. Give judgment for me, O Lord, for I have lived with integrity. I have trusted in the Lord and have not faltered. Test me, O Lord, and try me. Examine my heart and my mind. For your love is before my eyes. I have walked faithfully with you. I have not sat with the worthless, nor do I consort with the deceitful. I have hated the company of evildoers. I will not sit down with the wicked. I will wash my hands in innocence, O Lord, that I may go in procession round your altar. Sing aloud a song of thanksgiving, and recounting all your wonderful deeds. Lord, I love the house in which you dwell, and the place where your glory abides. Do not sweep me away with sinners, nor my life with those who thirst for blood, whose hands are full of evil plots, and their right hand full of bribes. As for me, I would live with integrity. Redeem me, O Lord, and have pity on me. My foot stands on level ground. In the full assembly, I will bless the Lord. Psalm 28. O Lord, I call to you, my rock. Do not be deaf to my cry, lest, if you do not hear me, I become like those who go down to the pit. Hear the voice of my prayer when I cry out to you, when I lift up my hands to your Holy of Holies. Do not snatch me away with the wicked or with the evildoers, who speak peaceably with their neighbors, while strife is in their hearts. Repay them according to their deeds, and according to the wickedness of their actions. According to the work of their hands, repay them, and give them their just deserts. They have no understanding of the Lord's doings, nor of the works of his hands. Therefore he will break them down and not build them up. Blessed is the Lord, for he has heard the voice of my prayer. The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusts in him, and I have been helped. Therefore my heart dances for joy, and in my song will I praise him. The Lord is the strength of his people, a safe refuge for his anointed. Save your people and bless your inheritance. Shepherd them and carry them forever. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 12 to 28. But we appeal to you, brothers and sisters, to respect those who labor among you and have charge of you in the Lord and admonish you. Esteem them very highly in love, because of their work. Be at peace among yourselves. And we urge you, beloved, to admonish the idlers, encourage the faint-hearted, help the weak, be patient with all of them. See that none of you repays evil for evil, but always seek to do good to one another and to all. Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Do not quench the spirit. Do not despise the words of prophets, but test everything. Hold fast to what is good. Abstain from every form of evil. May the God of peace himself sanctify you entirely. And may your spirit and soul and body be kept sound and blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will do this. Beloved, pray for us. Greet all the brothers and sisters with a holy kiss. I solemnly command you by the Lord that this letter be read to all of them. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Protect us. Blessed are you, Lord, the God of Israel. You have come to set your people, the Benedictus. Blessed are you, Lord, the God of Israel. You have come to your people and set them free. You have raised up for us a mighty Savior. The Benedictus. Blessed are you, Lord, the God of Israel. You have come to your people and set them free. You have raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of your servant David. Through your holy prophets, you promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our forebears, and to remember your holy covenant. This was the oath you swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship you without fear, holy and righteous before you all the days of our life. And you, child, shall be called a prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare the way, to give God's people knowledge of salvation, by the forgiveness of their sins, and the tender compassion of our God. The dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine upon those who dwell in darkness, and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet in the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Luke chapter 21, verses 29 to 38. Then he told them a parable. Look at the fig tree and all the trees. As soon as they sprout leaves, you can see for yourselves and know that summer is already near. So also, when you see these things taking place, you know that the kingdom of God is near. Truly I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. Be on guard, so that your hearts are not weighed down with dissipation and drunkenness and the worries of this life, and that day does not catch you unexpectedly, like a trap. For it will come upon all who live on the face of the whole earth. Be alert at all times, praying that you may have the strength to escape all these things that will take place and to stand before the Son of Man. Every day he was teaching in the temple, and at night he would go out and spend a night on the Mount of Olives, as it was called. And all the people will get up early in the morning to listen to him in the temple. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thou art the potter, I am the clay. Mold me and make me after thy will. While I am waiting, yielded and still. Have thine own way, Lord, have thine own way.
my dear friends in Christ. I come to you in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, as we reflect on Luke chapter 21, verses 29 to 38. Luke chapter 21, verses 29 to 38. And I thank God for his mercy, his grace, and I pray that he will use me as his vessel so that his will be done in my life and yours. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Be alert at all times, praying that you may have the strength to escape all these things that will take place and to stand before the Son of Man. If anything I have learned over the past couple of months is that life happens. Life happens whether you are prepared or you are ill-prepared, whether you take action or you take no action. Life happens. Approximately 2 months ago, I lost a friend who was very close to me. He was very young, 36 years old. And this past week, I had a series of reflections, basically a high and low. Last week Sunday, I had the opportunity to witness the joy of the commissioning of my friend Cicely and her daughter Cheyenne as lay ministers in their respective parish in St. Barnabas. Last week, I also had the opportunity, actually, that was last Saturday, to say farewell to Lestro Santo as we celebrated her life. And those of you who, if you recall, a couple months ago, I had the opportunity to broadcast one of our morning prayers from her home. And I also had the joy of celebrating the baptism of my godson, Azariah. So this past week and past few months, God has revealed to me in my personal journey of life, death, joy, sadness, comforting, and being comforted. And these are the things that we are called to do as Christians when God tells us to be alert at all times, praying that you have the strength to escape all things that will take place. Because it also says to be on guard, that your hearts will not be weighed down with dissipation and drunkenness and the worries of this life, and that day does not catch you unexpectedly. My dear friends in Christ, life, as I said a few moments ago, it happens. And we cannot avoid it. However, we have to say thanks to God for the many blessings and graces that he continues to bestow upon us. When we focus on the bad things in life, we tend to miss out on the blessings that God gives us. I spoke a little while ago about my friend, Gregory Robinson, who had passed. And in his passing, his life made such a profound change in the church, in the uniting of so many people. It was amazing. In his passing, in his life, in his 36 years of life when he passed unexpectedly, he brought so many young people back to the church in his death that God reminded us that even in death, there is life. The church, during the pandemic, in his passing, joined together in various physical and virtual services. My dear friends in Christ, when we are called up yonder, we have to ask ourselves, when we leave this earth, what kind of legacy are we leaving? How did we serve God giving? How did we serve God in giving ourselves? How much? And did we give God of the first fruits of ourselves? My dear friends and brothers and sisters in Christ, God is calling us to be prepared for the second coming. God is calling us to be prepared for when Jesus Christ comes again. God is calling us to be at peace and at love and at joy and to celebrate the happiness of Him day by day, hour by hour. Love God unconditionally through loving each other. We have experienced in 2020 such a bitter life. Many of us, we would have been affected in some way or the other. But remember, my dear friends, the kingdom of God is near. Are we prepared? Are we just giving God lip service? Are we just giving God the bare minimum of what he expects of us, or what we believe He expects of us? Are we truly giving of ourselves to God in ways that we cannot even begin to comprehend? Dear friends, brothers and sisters in Christ, let us not take God for granted. Our faith needs to be nurtured, just like a baby's, just like life. There are many of us who will be starting out on this journey of Christianity for the first time. And like a newborn baby, it needs to be treated tenderly. You need to handle it gently. We need to be able to bring happiness to this baby. We need to do what we have to do. Spend time. Feed it. Feed our faith. And as we see life continue to progress, we need to progress with it. We need to educate ourselves so that we will become and prepare our faith so that we will be prepared for what struggles lie ahead. Because as you go in faith, we grow as well in trials and tribulations. And as we continue to grow, we need to prepare ourselves. We need to take our faith to elementary school. We need to take our faith to secondary school. We need to take our faith as well to university and continue to grow. And I don't necessarily mean the physical study of hard certificates and these things, but practicing our faith, spending time daily in God's Word. God gave us life, dear friends in Christ. Are we going to take this life that God gave us for granted? Or are we going to do like the many people who have mentored us throughout our lives and grow in that faith? There are people we ourselves are called to mentor. So friends, let us not give up hope. Let's not. Because if we truly believe in God the Father Almighty, that He is the creator of heaven and earth, if we truly believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son of our God, if we believe in the power of the Holy Spirit, we ask God to give us that strength to be prepared, to give us that willingness to be able to go forward, to give us that opportunity that we continue in God's kingdom. You were chosen, dear friends in Christ. God chose you, just like he chose his disciples on that first day. God chose you. And we have to remember that that day when we see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory, people will faint from fear. But what would your position be? Would you be fearful and worried because we are not prepared? Or will we rejoice and say, yes, Lord Savior, here I am. Come, I am. Come receive me. I have been waiting. What will be our response to God when he comes again? What will be our response when God greets us at the pearly gates and he reviews our lives? Will he say to us, well done, good and faithful servant, you may enter the gates of heaven? Or would we hear, depart from me, for I do not know you? Have you decided to follow Jesus? Have you decided to reaffirm your faith in God? Dear friends, the time is now. Not tomorrow, not tonight, not next week, not for New Year's resolution. The time is now for us to follow Jesus. The time is now for us to get our lives back in order. I cannot force you, but I can invite you to drink of the cup of our Lord and Savior, to drink of the holy living water, to partake of his body and blood, to receive Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. Let us today make the decision to follow Jesus. In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let all mortal flesh keep silence, and with fear and trembling stand. Ponder nothing earthly minded, for with blessing in his hand, Christ our God to earth descended. A full homage to
Lord of lords in human vest,
Let us affirm our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. Let us truly, I urge us, reflect on what we are saying and mean the words we are saying and not merely recite the words. Let us truly believe what we are saying to God. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We come to our intercessions. As we reflect in our intercessions, we ask God to guide and guide us as we focus our attention on God's people everywhere. We pray for the Most Reverend Howard Gregory, Archbishop of the Province of the West Indies. We pray for the Right Reverend Claude Berkeley, Diocesan Bishop of Trinidad and Tobago. We pray for all retired bishops and members of clergy. At this point in time in our diocesan cycle of prayer, we pray for the parish of St. Thomas in Chaguanas. We pray for the Reverend Dr. Eric Thompson, who is priest in that parish. I also pray for the Reverend Enrique Moore, as he serves and he assists Father Thompson in that part of God's vineyard. In our own parish of St. Mary's in Tacarigua, we pray for the Reverend Dr. Anderson Maxwell, parish priest. We pray for the Reverend Father Titus Akbarali, assistant curate. And we pray for all deacons in the parish, the Reverend Theodore Finley, the Reverend Roderick Fanfare, and the Reverend Daniel Pontiflet Andre. We pray as well for all lay ministers and members of God's church, of this church, that God will continue to give them strength and courage to carry out the works that God has given us to do. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray a special prayer this morning for the young women of Trinidad and Tobago. We pray for the women who are victims, for all persons, women and men, who are focused or who are victims of crime, abuse, discrimination. We pray, dear God, that the women who are suffering, that they will find that refuge. We pray for peace in homes at this point in times. We pray, dear God, that your Holy Spirit would be with our families and our loved ones. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, whose Son Jesus Christ, born of a woman, sanctified childhood and shared the life of an earthly home, bless the homes and families of our nation. Give to parents a true sense of responsibility in the care and training of their children, that our boys and girls may grow up in the fear of your name and the fellowship of your church. For the glory of Christ our Lord. Amen. We pray for young people. We pray, O God, our Father, for our young people growing up in an unstable and confusing world. Show them, dear God, that your ways give more meaning to life than the ways of the world, and that following you is better than chasing after selfish goals. Help them to take failure not as a measure of their worth, but as a chance for a new start. Give them strength to hold their faith in you and to keep alive their joy in your creation. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And we pray as well for self-dedication as we continue to reflect on the words of God and the second coming of Christ in this Advent season. Almighty and eternal God, so draw our hearts to you, so guide our minds, so fill our imaginations, so control our wills, that we may be wholly yours, utterly dedicated to you. Use us, we pray, you, as you will, and always your glory and welfare of your people, through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. The collect for this week. For the second Sunday of Advent. Merciful God, who sends your messengers, the prophets, to preach the repentance and to prepare the way for our salvation, give us grace to heed their warnings and forsake our sins, that we may greet with the joy of the coming of Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. A prayer of dedication. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet and a light to our paths and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Before we go, we would like to say special birthday. Send special birthday greetings to those celebrating birthdays this week. Cheryl Noriga, whose birthday was the 4th. Cynthia Simon, whose birthday was the 9th, will be the 9th. Grisella Hutchison Graves, whose birthday will be the 11th. And to Jean Umilta Busby, Kurt Swan, and Keisha Fraser, all of whom will be celebrating their birthdays on the 12th. May God richly bless each and every one of you as you seek God's word and you celebrate the life that God has given you and as we celebrate another year of life. Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than we can ask or imagine, by the power which is at work among us, to him be the glory in the church and in Christ Jesus, throughout all ages. Amen. My brothers and sisters in Christ, the church, the service of Zenith, the Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God.